Inanda. A place, a place. A place that has woven together extraordinary people and produced extraordinary stories. When you journey through this landscape, you will uncover a history of struggle and resistance. Inanda has three significant historical sites: the Phoenix settlement founded by Mahatma Gandhi, the Inanda Seminary, the first secondary school for African girls, and the Ohlange High School, where Nelson Mandela casted his first vote.
Welcome to the Phoenix settlement founded by Mahatma Gandhi in 1904. Gandhi stayed here in South Africa for 21 years. He laid the foundation for passive resistance against injustice. When Gandhi found this settlement here, he found it to be a very nice place, very clean, full of plants. There was no houses then, 100 years ago. And he started the settlement here after studying the book by Ruskin until the last. What a communal settlement can be, how people can stay and live together.
All of you, you know it's true. Thank you very much.
Inanda Seminary is a secondary girls boarding school for black South Africans. And the school has been in existence since 1869. The school opened on March 1st, 1869. So we're coming up on a 145 years of history. Most schools like this were closed because they provided a superior education than that which the apartheid regime intended for people of color. The oldest structure on our campus was built in 1857 by Reverend Daniel Lindley. He and his wife Lucy and their 11 children lived in this house. And this house is still used today as the administrative block of the school. Our second oldest building is Edwards Hall. Young girls were forced to marry, often in polygamous relationships, much older men, chiefs. And sometimes these girls, they would come to the mission station. They would run away. And Mary Kelly Edwards, in many ways, allowed this institution to be a sort of safe place, a refuge, for those young black women who were running away from forced marriages. Rate. So the school very much still provides one of the best educations. So while we're very, very proud of our history and our legacy, we are still working very, very hard today. And as you can see, we are building for the future. And while we're almost 145 years old, we are quite confident that we'll continue to provide South Africa with very competent, successful black female leadership for the next 150 years into the future.
Also, the reason why Nelson Mandela decided to come and cast his first democratic vote at Ohlange Institute, because he wanted to honor the life and time of co-founder and first president of ANC, Dr. John Langalibalele Dube. After Mandela, after he finished his vote, he acknowledged the significance of Dr. John Langalibalele Dube's grave. And he visited in front of King Charles of the World, top ANC officials, IEC top officials, and the Dube family. And he laid a replica of a flower, of which it was a symbol of respect. And after he laid a replica of a flower, Dr. Nelson Mandela, he stood right at the middle of Dr. John Langalibalele Dube's grave. And he made a very, very significant statement in front of the ministers of the world. And he said, "Mr. President, I've come to report to you that today South Africa is free. May your soul rest in peace now."
The Inanda heritage route. It is one route that it's not very known to our tourists. We always refresh our minds about our history, where we come from, so that we don't forget who we are, where we come from, what is our history. So to visit these areas, it's very fulfilling. And when you listen to the history, even for the people who started these places, you can see that there was some sort of oppression where they come from. But they did not fold their arms and say, okay, it's fine, we accept what is happening to us. But they said, no, they want to help others so that others can be educated, so that they can be able to deal with whatever situation. Because if a person is educated, she or he is able to deal with whatever that person is faced with.